Hello, everyone. This is gonna be some main questing. So, what happened? Well, I got transported or teleported somewhere. No idea where I'm at. And I let myself just get captured and locked up. Even though I could have clearly beaten the guy. Alright. Well, that's how stories like this usually go. Let's see what happens. This has got to be in the past. Kingdom of Ethanic? Then... Well, that's a lot of running around in this house. Okay, I knew past Ethne was advanced, but I didn't think it was this advanced. Guess I'll find out what happened to it all. Huh. That's right, the dwarves were technologically advanced too, so I wonder how advanced the other races were. But apparently something happened that drove the dwarves to war and they lost all their technology. I wonder if the same thing happened to the other races.
That's just one thing after another. Thank you.
I need to get new rods. Quite a few fish here.
Thank you.
When I'm back in town, I gotta get more rods and lures. I gotta sell a few things soon. Thing is, there is something with monetary value you can sell for fish coins. I'm mainly doing it to get all those rewards, but I mean, you can make a profit out of fishing. The thing is, I need to use these expensive powerful rods until my fishing level is strong enough to where I can just use cheap rods, maybe 20-30k gold rods and lures, and still be able to get any fish. So thing is, though, I have no idea how high fishing levels can go. I'm able to catch some pretty hardcore fish already at my current fishing level. It's 18. So max fishing level could be 20, could be 25. Could be 30, I don't know. I've been trying to check what the max fishing level is, trying some Google searches, with translated Japanese with no success. Oh, I forgot to do that. Go back to here in a sec. Let me just, I gotta get that done. Back before they took it away completely, you had the offline campaign with your by controlling your own your sibling, which for my case would have been Minami, to basically try to get back to your home village, which for her was about 50 years in the past. But it seemed that she discovered time travel. That's how she was able to come back to this time. Got herself involved with stuff. So now I'm just trying to find her again. But that was the goal of your adventure from the start, is to find your sister or brother, depending on what you made. From what I know, the entire story arc ends at 5.0. It's up there, really. Alright, let's try to get there. But yeah, my sibling, well, your sibling had to go through all this stuff. And she was able to actually enter those buildings that are locked to me. Oh, nice. Definitely use that. Combine it with the other full moon rings I've got. The thing is, this ring is nice. To be quite honest, rings are really meant to have a or try to get a status immunity to something. Like this, for example, Confused Guard. That and with Holy Impenetrable, and maybe just throwing on a, if I could get, like, because these aren't even the King stats, I bet the highest King stat for this would be maybe 7% each. It'd be funny if it was 10%. But, yeah, if I could get, like, 70% Confused Guard or any guard, and I use Holy Impenetrable, I'm set. I'd be immune. because this other synthesis does nothing for me. I have to find out where, what bosses I have to kill or where to find them to start trying to get these grinded out. That's something I'll do eventually. I just have to look it up on one of the Japanese sites and it'll tell me exactly where I can find them. Yeah, I used to be able to enter these in the offline sibling campaign that, again, they took out in favor of just telling the story through, well, the game itself, the online game. Again, I don't know why. I mean, that offline campaign with your sibling is makes for a very good tutorial. You still play it if you own the Weave and maybe the Wii U version of the game? Somebody in the Dragon's Den actually translated the entire thing to English. Did a real good job of it, too. I don't think I saw a lick of Japanese when I played it way back then. I have videos of it. It's in my channel somewhere. Deep, deep in my channel. But, he did really, really well. And I'm hoping that, well, the thing is, the offline files, I don't think they were encrypted as much as the online stuff is, if at all. I mean, Serenity could easily do everything that guy did with the, well, the actual game, if he's able to unencrypt or decrypt all those files. It's a long-term process, and I'm pretty sure he's working hard at it, but hey, at least he's having fun doing it, right? Reverse engineering and decrypting things is what Serenity finds fun. So I'm looking forward to how far he can go. Okay, there's gotta be a reason why there's a church and safe here. Gotta have something to do with. Yeah, like I said, Tombstone here. You change classes here. This has got to be some sort of side content that I haven't unlocked yet. Well, all I can do really is quest and adventure around, and I'll eventually find out everything. That's my main goal. I mean, others are going to try to speed through the main quest like Sauce is trying to do. Others are going to take their time and maybe explore me. I'm trying to be a completionist and do everything so I can help the community out better and make more videos to help everybody else out. It's gonna take me time. Even my new members are probably gonna get through main quest storyline faster than I am, because I'm doing all this side stuff. Only just now and then just doing the main story like I am right now. What was in those buildings that the sibling can enter in the offline campaign? They were generally very beautiful, white, reflective rooms with a boss in them. They all held a crest or something, I think. It's way back then. Part of a key that you had to pretty much go to five, six different buildings to form the seal needed to open the waypoint station to get back to the Etain Village. Ooh, shiny. Makes no sense for spells like that to completely ignore your spell resistance. See, everybody has to make age jokes on the ogre. I had to go into the Discord for something. Alright, back to the Sage's office. Well, it's getting late. And let's keep going. Oh boy, am I gonna run up and down stairs some more? So it looks like we went a little further into the, well, a little, tiny little bit less of the past than before. It looks like the house is destroyed. All right.
Thank you.
No walkthrough. Oh, that's great. Let's see. I can't exit, so... I see. I gotta get to the basement. Too damn dark. Okay. Just temporarily until I can. Because this place is just so damn dark. Man, everything's a freaking mess. Thank you. Damn it, I'm running in circles here. I know I have to find a furnace somewhere, but I'm just not seeing it. And it looks like I have no walkthrough, so I can't get a clear identification of where I'm supposed to go. Oh, we got light now. Oh, there's that cliche. About to beat some soldiers up now. Of course. This world map music's unique. Well, at least I think. I mean, I played many
I played many of the non-mainline Dragon Quest games. Heroes, Builders. I think one of the monster games. But there's still plenty I haven't played. I have played all the main franchise games, of course. But hey, if this is music from one of those other games, just let me know in the comments, please. Geography of the island and the kingdom doesn't match, so I wonder if this island was just an offshoot of the kingdom or some sort. Well, it's 5,000 years in the past, so no idea. All you can carry is 20. You can't even store them. So I really should do some Zomia ruins at some point. Even though I'm planning to make or purchase my armor. I mean, I might get lucky and get something good. Who knows? Thank you. Ah, that must be for the quest I'm doing. Or all the sub-quests I got. Let's see. Okay, so it's something I'm gonna have to discover on my own while running about. Alright. Or I can just look up the quest and get all the locations that way. It's something I'll do eventually. I see. It's probably something I have to unlock. Okay. I'll keep a note of it. Wait, this whole continent's floating in the sky, right? Okay, so if that's the case, then whatever happened to bring it crashing down, the remnants must have became the island of... Okay, that makes more sense. Okay, so instead of using Zoom stones, I could just use this cube to go around to places, I guess. Alright.
Thank you.
Alright, I'm gonna stop the recording here. It's past 4 a.m. and I'm tired. Hope you all enjoyed it. I will see you on the next recording. Take care.